A warm welcome to you from Fred Taylor Park in Whenuapai. It's the ASB Premiership semi-final second leg between Waitakere United and Hawke's Bay United. And the weather here, as you can tell by these pictures, is absolutely superb for today's second leg semi-final. Waitakere United, of course, last week went down to Napier and triumphed by 4-1. No team in the history of the ASB Premiership has been able to haul back a 3-goal deficit like that. So Hawke's Bay have their work cut out this afternoon. The weather here, of course, is going to play a part, you would think. It's around about 25 degrees Celsius. There is no wind and not a cloud in the sky. And the prize, of course, awaiting the winner is a place in the ASB Premiership Grand Final for March the 17th. But just a confirmation of those semi-final results. Waitakere United lead Hawke's Bay United 4-1. And in the other semi-final, Auckland City defeated Canterbury United 2-1. That match is hanging delicately in the balance. Of course, a couple of seasons ago, Canterbury United lost to Auckland City 2-1 in the first leg before going up to Kiwatea Street and winning 3-0. So that game is scheduled for Sunday. And you can see there, 4-point advantage for Waitakere United in taking out the minor premiership. It's the fifth occasion they've managed to do that. And to the Waitakere lineup, only two key changes here. Danny Robinson takes his place in goal for the minor premiers. He missed out last week due to a family illness. Alex Carr goes to the bench. And you can see that it's pretty much the back four that we've seen for most of this season. Tim Myers slots in at left back, though, in place of Tristan Prattley, who was also missing last weekend. Butler and Matthews hold down those two holding positions in front of the back four. And Dan Morgan is starting the game. There's no Chad Coombs. He's been rested. Now we go to the Hawke's Bay lineup. Josh Margetts is out of the starting lineup. He's been replaced by Matt Bruin. And Bill Robinson and Aaron Jones locked down that back four in the midfield. Cole Peverley, who was on the score sheet last week, the former All-White. Harley Rodecker and Connor Tinian will be most important. Hawke's Bay United need goals today. They need to win this match 4-0 or even 4-1 to take it to extra time. But as we've said before, it's going to be a very big ask. It's going to be an extremely difficult ask for Hawke's Bay to come back from this deficit. But stranger things have happened in football. They won't be giving it up so easily. The first goal today could determine the type of match that we're about to witness. Two quick goals, or a quick goal for Hawke's Bay United might tip this tie on its head, but we'll see. Referee for today is Matt Conger. It's been a remarkable season of football for Hawke's Bay United. It's their first time in the ASB Premiership semi-finals. It took 9 years for Hawke's Bay to reach knockout football in the ASB Premiership. Plenty for coach Chris Greatholder to build upon. Napier is a stronghold of football. It's one of the best venues to go and watch an ASB Premiership match at Bluewater Stadium. And they'll want more of this. They'll want to give a good account of themselves in the second leg. It would be so easy for Waitakere to just fall into a sense of complacency. There was a lot of relaxed players out there prior to kickoff in the warm-up. There's not as much pressure on them as there was prior to kickoff last week. But they did get caught out. They were going for an unbeaten record in the minor premiership. And Canterbury United came up here and turned Waitakere over by 3-2. So Waitakere's pursuit of four consecutive ASB Premiership titles goes on the line. It's all about survival for Hawke's Bay United. There are no tomorrows for them. A seventh consecutive ASB Premiership Grand Final also beckons for Waitakere. And earlier in the week, Coach Paul Marshall slipped somewhat out of character and spoke about Waitakere being just around the corner from sealing a treble. So there's so many records on the line. Football history calling out to the West Aucklanders. Well, it's so good to see Dan Morgan back playing football. He injured his knee in the Super City Derby with Auckland on the same pitch in November last year, and he's been rehabbing that leg. As we get underway at Fred Taylor Park, Waitakere lead by 4-1 on aggregate. The first goal will be so crucial. Brian Shelley clipping a ball forward for Krishna. Aaron Jones gets his head on it and it's through to the goalkeeper, Richard Gillespie. Well, he's one of the most decorated goalkeepers in ASB Premiership competition history, Richard Gillespie, and he's played a lot of his football here. Oh, and that's not a bad ball. Danny Robinson having to come off his line as Matt Conger, the referee, slips and falls to the ground. And Shelley's just overhit that one. Back with Gillespie. Well, he's going to go long and direct here. Flicked on by Lucas. Nodded back by Shelley. So this could be the preferred route for Hawke's Bay United today to get the ball forward as fast as they possibly can. Aaron Jones. Picked up by Butler. Now Krishna can run at Hawke's Bay here. First shot. Oh, and it's ended up in the back of the net. The strangest of goals. Here is Krishna running at Hawke's Bay for the first time. He didn't get much power on it. It's taken a deflection. And Richard Gillespie can only watch on in horror as the ball ends up in the back of the net. Perfect start for Waitakere. Roy Krishna's 15th goal of the season. And it's a hammer blow for Hawke's Bay United. They so desperately needed the first goal here today to try and change the dynamics and put some pressure on the hosts, but it's all gone terribly wrong, terribly early. And that's given straight to Aaron Scott, and Waitakere can counter-attack again through Alan Pearce. Krishna's ball through for Scott. Not a bad one, and Gillespie read it. Had to be on his toes. And Aaron Scott winning the ball. Well, that's gone Hawke's Bay's way, sorry. Fergus Neal will take the throw. Harley Rodecker for Hawke's Bay, trying to find a way through. That's a good overlapping run. Ball into the centre. Oh, and it's just over the crossbar. And it looks as though there's been a clash of heads there. Two Hawke's Bay players crossing paths. This was a nice ball in. It was inviting. And just a collision, not on target. That didn't trouble Danny Robinson. Robertson does well to get a foot on it. Dan Morgan's picked it up. Alan Pierce on the right, attacking Fergus Neal. Decides to go against Neal, and he's clipped the cross in too far. There's that direct ball. Dakota Lucas has managed to draw Robinson off his line to clear that one. And there's a call from Paul Marshall. He's concerned that some of these long balls from Hawke's Bay United are being won by the Hawke's Bay strikers. Matt Kinnean to Brian Shelley, taking it forward, trying to find a way through. Dakota Lucas snapping away at his heels. Now Krishna. Pierce. Aaron Scott with a long ball forward, looking for Dan Morgan. He's got some wheels. Oh, and that's almost straight into the path of De Vries. Chance for Morgan. Oh, and he's hit it straight at the goalkeeper. Well, free kick. And look at this chance here. A back heel from Ryan De Vries, and Dan Morgan, well, had no power on it at all, and it was thankfully, from a Hawke's Bay perspective at least, straight into the hands of Richard Gillespie. So the free kick to be taken by Dan Morgan. Fired into the far post. Gillespie thinks about coming for it. It's nodded away by Robertson. Well, this is the danger for Hawke's Bay United. They've conceded the early goal. They trail 5-1. And by opening themselves up, they could be on the end of a goal deluge if they're not careful. Morgan attempting to turn, but he's won the ball back in any case. Sprays it wide to Matt Kinnean. Kinnean, of course, with a Hawke's Bay background. He was pretty excited when the draw was known. An opportunity to return to Bluewater Stadium, where Kinnean used to play for Napier City Rovers. Here's Cole Peverley. Again, that direct ball looking for Connor Tinian. Well, a feature of this Hawke's Bay United side has been their ability to change up the style and the approach that they've had in games, between getting the ball forward as fast as possible to being able to knock the ball around and play in the counter-attack. Well, that's a bit of an interesting clearance from Brian Shelley. Nobody's coming to claim it. And there's Danny Robinson taking control. Well, Tim Myers has gone down in a heap, and that is going to be an opportunity for him to receive treatment. He looks in some degree of pain, Tim Myers. Here is another look at this interesting goal now. Perplexing moment. Bill Robertson flagged it away. It's hard to tell if it's taking a deflection. Oh, and it might have actually taken a bit of a knock off Alan Pierce. We'll have another look at this. No? Well, in any case, the result was the main feature of that attempt. And Richard Gillespie just caught out. Myers is back on his feet and we can resume play here at Fred Taylor Park. Well, just one defeat for Waitakere United in the entire season. That 3-2 defeat to Canterbury United, and they've just looked a different class this season. Last season, they struggled to make it to the grand final. There was a distinct feeling amongst a lot of observers that this Waitakere side was going to perhaps even struggle to qualify for the Oceania Champions League, but they pulled it out of the fire. They've got problems here, though. Dakota Lucas, another former Waitakere player. It's a nice turn. It's an opportunity to get the ball in the box, and it's just cleared by Brian Shelley. Clipped in by Peverley, and the header ineffective. So we're in the 11th minute here at Fred Taylor Park. Waitakere United 1, Hawke's Bay United 0. And 5-1 on aggregate in favour of Waitakere. Well, Team Wellington were the side that missed out on the semi-finals this season after they finished runners-up in the grand final. Come back to that point in a moment. Here's Fergus Neal. Not a bad ball in by Neal. Shelley's read it. Chance here for Peverley. Oh, and he's miscued completely. He possesses an absolutely deadly shot from distance, Cole Peverley. And his eyes would have lit up at that opportunity. Here it is here. It's an absolute gimme by his standards, and end result not good enough. I recall Peverley scoring in the Olympic Games qualifiers for New Zealand against Fiji with an absolute cracker of a long-range shot. That was back in 2008. Well, Hawke's Bay are just lacking a, or possessing a heavy touch when they're getting into the top third at the moment. If they can manage to relax a little bit more and have a softer touch on the ball, they might be able to take advantage of some of the good positions they're taking up. As we watch Dan Morgan pour forward, shot from Pierce is a harmless one. All-time leading goal scorer for the ASB Premiership, Alan Pearce. He's had to play second string very much to Roy Krishna this season. Morgan. Here's Krishna. Well picked up by Bill Robertson. Now Peverley. Decent ball in. Oh, and Robinson's come. Can Hawke's Bay fashion a chance? Dakota Lucas on the right foot. Oh, he's at the post. So close for Hawke's Bay. A real wake-up call for Waitakere. Well, Hawke's Bay poured forward in numbers and Lucas decided to measure a shot rather than blasting it, and he almost got it right. Neal. Now Lucas again. Aaron Jones, better period of play now for Hawke's Bay. Belief growing perhaps that the visitors can pull a goal back. Jones. Lucas. Well, Waitakere pressing Hawke's Bay on the ball every opportunity they get. Good touch by Neil. He's played Lucas in. Numbers pouring forward for the Bay. Six players in the penalty area for Hawke's Bay. Dakota Lucas is going to need a hand here. It's come in the form of Alan Pierce. Now Matthews. Morgan. Nice touch from Krishna. He's picked out DeVries. Gillespie thought about coming. Ryan DeVries. Oh, and he's just managed to get the ball off to Krishna. Well, Waitakere players are queuing up for support. Nice turn from Krishna. Bill Robertson manages to get the ball off the foot of Jake Butler. Now Hawke's Bay can break. Another long ball searching for Lucas. Oh, and he's done Brian Shelley a treat here. Lucas, oh, and he's hit it into the side netting. Good opportunity for Hawke's Bay. Was it the right option? It came from a long ball. Brian Shelley just got the wrong side of Lucas. Former Waitakere player has wasted a good opportunity. There was help arriving at the near post. The right attitude. Execution left a lot to be desired. Hoyle. Jones long ball. This time Shelley deals with it well. This is Hoyle, sorry. Now Peverley. Ball wound into the penalty area. Away by Matt Kinnean. Well, Hawke's Bay are playing like a team who have nothing to lose at the moment. Lucas with a header. Oh, and it's just wide. Danny Robinson calling for his teammates to lift their work rate. The last thing they want to do is just slip into a form of complacency here, because we saw what happened in round 14 against Canterbury. Robertson. All the way back to Gillespie. Well played by the Bay skipper. He's been the bedrock of Hawke's Bay's run to the knockout stages of the ASB Premiership. Ryan DeVries thinks about having a long-range shot. Decides to play Pearson. Back on his left foot, Pierce. No power. Good tempo to this game. Hawke's Bay's direct route football is serving them well so far. Matthews, Morgan. Kinnean goes long, and there's no way DeVries was going to ever reach that. Victory for Waitakere United today will mean the ASB Premiership Grand Final will be played on home ground as Butler lines himself up for a shot, perhaps. Alan Pierce on the left foot takes a deflection and all the way through to the goalkeeper. Hindmarch. Stephen Hoyle. A lot to be admired about Hawke's Bay season. Team Wellington had a star-studded lineup. Themselves, they were by no means a poor side this season. Neil winds in the cross, headed away by Shelley. Oh, and the keeper's come for it. Chance for Lucas. Well, there's a claim that there was a hand outside the penalty area. I think it was a bit of a reach for Matt Conger to consider that an offence. But Hawke's Bay are knocking on the door. Heavily. Tinian. Hindmarch. First touch was quite heavy. Alan Pierce. Now Krishna. Well, Robertson doesn't want to get caught one-on-one with him. Peverly starts another attack. Stephen Hoyle. Fergus Neal. Lucas. Hindmarch's ball forward is not a bad one. Lucas has kept his run going. He's gone down. It's a penalty. Matt Conger gives Hawke's Bay a penalty. Another long ball forward, and the left back got ahead of Matt Kinnean. Was there contact? Matt Conger thought so. And it's going to be Cole Peverley, who scored last week. Up against Danny Robinson. He had to face Alex Carr in Napier. This week it's Robinson. A big moment for the Bay. Cole Peverley, and he scores. It's all level here at Fred Taylor Park. In the second leg, it's now 5-2 on aggregate. Well, they'll need three more of those to get this tie back in their favour. Danny Robinson went to his left. Peverley chose in the opposite direction. Well, it was maybe not a correct decision. It was hard to see where Kinnean actually made contact with Fergus Neal, but you have to say on the balance of play, Hawke's Bay are worth a goal at least at the moment. Oh, and Neal brings down Alan Pierce. That's a clear free kick. Neil was never going to get there in time. He's got a bit of the ball, but most of Alan Pierce, and that's what Matt Conger saw. So Morgan's free kick. Plenty of bend on it. Away by Hawke's Bay. Now Harley Roddicker can break. Well, can Hawke's Bay make the impossible happen? Can they retrieve this deficit? Jones long ball away by Kinnean, only as far as Connor Tinian. Peverley's got it back. Now Hoyle, first time ball in, away by Kinnean. Matthews, that's a short, tight ball to give Brian Shelley, but he's dealt with it. Oh, and that's a crunching tackle on Krishna. It's taken quickly. Morgan. Twice Morgan's given the ball away, and Hawke's Bay have given it straight back to him off either a deflection or a wayward return pass. Pierce for Butler. Surveys his options. Finds Krishna. Aaron Jones. Long ball again from Jones. They're looking to exploit that space just in behind the right back. Waitakere's right back position. Waitakere United 1, Hawke's Bay United 1. Robertson's header. Krishna eludes Robertson. That's a nice ball by Krishna. It's been picked up by Gillespie, who needed to be on his toes. Pierce. That's a corner. So some of that pressure from Hawke's Bay has been alleviated. At least for now. They've managed to get a lot of traction off these corners this season, Waitakere, particularly against Hawke's Bay United. Jake Butler's prospered from set plays a couple of times this season. That's a good ball. That's an excellent ball. Lucas, now he'll fancy taking on Matthews here. He's done well. Still going. Chance for Hawke's Bay. 2-1. Sensational stuff. 27 minutes gone. Hawke's Bay are in front.
Second goal for Hawke's Bay United. Number 11, Connor Tinian. Taking the
4-2. 2-1. Connor Tinian. Is the miracle on? Lucas managed to get the ball into the 6-yard box, and Tinian just shrugged off his marker and slots it home. Remarkable moment. Five, three on aggregate. Well, for those of you who thought that perhaps this tie was dead and buried in Napier, think again. Can Waitakere respond? No, not from Dan Morgan, not that time. Well, what were we talking about before? Referencing that match with Canterbury United. Now if Hawke's Bay can pinch a third, and it's 5-4 on aggregate, they only need another two goals. Dan Morgan with a shot, bit better than his last attempt. Well, two goals for Hawke's Bay would take the game into extra time. It would be 5-5 on aggregate. That ball clipped forward. Tim Myers has to deal with it. I'll tell you what, Hawke's Bay are looking good at the moment. Fergus Neal's header. Brian Shelley under pressure. Neil again. Dakota Lucas. Oh, it's not a bad ball in either. Waitakere, you're on the ropes. Hoyle whips it in. Away by Myers. Here's Lucas. Oh, that's a good ball. Who's on the end of it? Oh, and so close for Hawke's Bay then. They've got a corner. That's a great ball in by Dakota Lucas to the back post. Bredeker at the near post. It's whipped in. There's a bit of curve on it. Oh, and it's anyone's ball. It's another corner. Well, we're on the half-hour mark. It's Waitakere United 1, Hawke's Bay United 2. And the Bay are in control, would you believe? Another set play wound in. Danny Robinson's got it. That's a great take by the goalkeeper. Just the type of moment Waitakere were looking for to take the pressure off, because they have been put under the hammer. There is a corner wound in. Players queuing up for it. Bill Robertson there, and the strong hands of Danny Robinson to the rescue for Waitakere. It's been an aerial bombardment from Hawke's Bay so far, and you know, they are getting in behind Waitakere from some of these long balls, and they're also picking up seconds off some of those headers, and that's exactly what they would have been looking to achieve today. A third goal would really set up a wonderful second half, you would think, if Hawke's Bay can manage it. Here's Lucas. Cross into the near post, away by Shelley. Tinian's picked it up. Can't go past Myers. Dan Morgan's long ball out to Krishna. Who would have picked this? Waitakere 1, Hawke's Bay 2. Jones on a foray forward for Hawke's Bay. Oh, and the flag just went up, and Dakota Lucas was offside. Waitakere United got their line right there. They're an experienced unit.
As always, Waitakere United would like to acknowledge the community support we receive from the Hugh Sports Foundation and the Trust.
And he's offside by a good margin.
And the bar running downstairs to the touch shop. And on the far side of the pitch under the AC tent, there's a sausage sizzle running, and you can get cold drinks from there as well.
Minutes to the break, and Waitakere have had to absorb a flurry of punches from Hawke's Bay United. In knockout football, you can never write anybody off, it seems. Waitakere United managed a comeback of gargantuan proportions last season. Of course, they were beaten by Canterbury at Fred Taylor Park. And then they were trailing 2-1 at halftime in the return leg before winning 5-2. Good ball in, away by Scott. Real sense here that Hawke's Bay could perhaps pull another one back. Long range shot, and it's well wide. Interesting build up from Hawke's Bay. Well, referee Matt Conger is going to have a word to his assistant on the far side. Perhaps some words said out of turn, who knows? Well, Matt Conger is having a word to Tim Myers and Jake Butler. Headed on by DeVries. Aaron Jones. Now Aaron Scott in trouble here. Well, the weather conditions today are sweltering. There's been no rain in Auckland for a good many weeks now. And it will be taking its toll on these players. Big question mark for Chris Greatholder will be, can Hawke's Bay keep this breakneck pace up as they go in search of more goals. Fergus Neal, Cole Peverley, well read by DeVries, not known for his defending, but he did well there. DeVries again. He's given that straight back to Josh Margetts. Neal for Hindmarch, who's given it away. That's a good... Oh, well, I don't know about that. That, to me, looked a fair challenge by Cole Peverley. He is a physical player. We'll need to have a look at that again. Well, look... Well, I take that back. Peverley was fully cognizant of what he was about to do there. And when you shape your body position like that, you're really inviting the referee to give a free kick. Whether or not you won the ball, it's all about how it looked in the eyes of the official, who of course doesn't have the benefit of a multiple array of replays as we do.
Just a reminder that the other semi-final.
So here's another look at that goal for Connor Tinian. He just pushed Krishna off and slots the ball home. Remarkable stuff. I mean, you look back in the records of the ASB Premiership and you'll be hard-pushed to find too many teams who have come back from three goals down. They're not quite there yet, but they're giving it a jolly good go, Hawke's Bay. Well, we'll restart with a free kick. Dan Morgan to take. He's aimed for the penalty spot, straight down the throat of Gillespie. Peverley, long ball forward. Tinian breaking clear of Aaron Scott, but he was offside. Another look at that free kick. That's an easy one for Gillespie. There's... no Waitakere or Hawke's Bay United play anywhere near it. Can Waitakere find a way out of this minor spot of bother? They've been so assured. I mean, so often in the past as well, the minor premiers have come a cropper either in the final or in the semi-final. Which is all part of a wider debate about playoff football and determining who the champions are, whether it be a league basis or this current league and knockout format that exists in the Premiership. Certainly makes for exciting football for us. Kinnean heads back comfortably to Robinson. Brian Shelley. Scott. Lucas, oh, and this has allowed Hall to come through with a chance. Oh, and he's hit it straight at the goalkeeper. Sorry, Stephen Hindmarch, it was. It was a golden opportunity to go 3-1 up. Tinian does well to win it back for Peverley. Now Margaret. There's real concern down there on the Waitakere bench at the moment. Paul Marshall's not slow in coming forward. This was the ball that let Highmarch through, and then the left foot shot, he scuffed it and didn't get any luck with the rebound either. Well, Waitakere won the round six clash between these two sides 3-1 on this venue. Oh, that's a lovely ball from Roy Krishna for Ryan DeVries. Dan Morgan steaming up on his left. That's a good ball through and a chance. Good save by Gillespie. DeVries for Butler. Now Krishna, can he get past Robertson? Goes to the far post. They're queuing up. Through Ryan DeVries. DeVries goes to ground easily, but you can't do that, Aaron Jones. That's not the position you want to be going in physically there. And Ryan DeVries is a cool customer and experienced player who will be more than aware that that's a good position to go down. And that's a good run by Dan Morgan. Great save from Gillespie. Now, an opportunity for Jake Butler to hit this. We all know that Butler can really strike a dead ball. Perhaps this to put Hawke's Bay back in their place. We're just 3.5 minutes away from the 45-minute mark. We're going to see a set play of some type here. A rehearsed move, perhaps. It's going to be Butler. Oh, and it's just over the crossbar. Not far away at all. Peverley. Oh, and he's put Robertson in all sorts of problems. It's been picked up by Krishna. A chance to go level before the break. And he takes it. Hawke's Bay are punished. Deadly finishing from Roy Krishna. 2-2. Well, it's all unraveled for Hawke's Bay. All the hard work. And Roy Krishna took on Aaron Jones, went past him, and then rifled home the left foot shot. A real blow for Hawke's Bay, but that man, Roy Krishna, 16 goals this season. He's in his most prolific form. He's often been criticised in the past for not being as productive in front of goal as he is in other areas of the pitch, Roy Krishna, but there can be no argument this season. He's been in absolutely deadly form, and he's been the difference today between these two sides. So near, yet so far for Hawke's Bay. You think back to that earlier chance for Stephen Hindmarch. Had that gone in, might have been 3-1, but Waitakere can come forward. That's a good ball in by Krishna. With Dan Morgan steaming up in the far post. Matthews. Morgan looking to dig one out for Pierce. Margaret's got something on it. Away by Robertson. Morgan. Might be something here for Waitakere. Oh, and a chance for a hat-trick for Krishna. Good save from Gillespie. Magnificent save from the Hawke's Bay United goalkeeper. Excellent build-up. It had Hawke's Bay in all sorts of problems, but it was the left hand of Gillespie that kept them in it. Or at least kept them in this particular part of the match. The tie is dangling by a thread for Hawke's Bay. That three-goal cushion restored. It's taken some of that pressure off Waitakere. Can they add to it? Corner to the near post. Hooked away by Peverley. Helped on by Rodiker. De Vries. Exchanges passes with Butler. That's a good effort from... Oh, he's hit the bar! Dan Morgan's completely miscued the follow-up. Hawke's Bay still haven't cleared it. There's one or two weary-looking Bay players. Have the exertions been slightly too much in this heat? We'll see. Here is De Vries with that lovely Cruyff turn, and then just elects to clip a ball in with the left foot. Look at that. Gillespie saw it and didn't even bother to go for it, and then crashing off the crossbar. This is Hoyle. Now Tinian. Tinian might fancy a go himself. Hoyle. That's an easy one for Danny Robinson. Tim Myers venturing forward. He's in a good position. Myers, he's got nobody in the penalty area to hit, though. Nice exchange. There's a long-range shot and just wide of the post by Alan Pierce. Margets. And Robertson is the last player to touch the ball as referee Matt Conger blows his whistle for half time. An entertaining first 45 minutes here at Fred Taylor Park. Hawke's Bay have thrown the kitchen sink at Waitakere, and it came up with some rewards for them. They fell behind early to a Roy Krishna goal after just 2 minutes. And goals in quick succession to Cole Peverley from the penalty spot, and Connor Tinian gave Hawke's Bay a 2-1 advantage that they looked as though they would hold on to until half time, and then it all came apart at the seams when Krishna levelled on 42 minutes. So let's recap on the first half of action that we've seen here today. This was the opening goal after just 2 minutes. Roy Krishna's first attack on goal. It was a long-range shot, didn't have much power. There might have been a hint of a deflection. But when he gets running at defences, defences start to open up. And as we've seen so often in the past, Roy Krishna knows his way to goal. That was his 15th strike of the season. And the ideal start for the minor premiers. A horror start for Hawke's Bay United. Well, Hawke's Bay weren't too slow in coming forward. Dakota Lucas' shot striking the upright. It was a lovely measured effort here. Brian Shelley did well to stand him up. There was no direct shot on goal, and he had to try and fashion something out of the magic tricks box. Now, it was all direct from Hawke's Bay in the first half. This ball sprayed forward, saw Brian Shelley knocked off his stride by Dakota Lucas. He was zeroing in on goal. Had an option to hit the near post. I think it was Connor Tinian who had managed to get into the six-yard box. Lucas checked his options and then produced an unimpressive effort on goal. 4 minutes later, opportunity for Waitakere United, but they've just lacked a bit of power in some of their shots today. Alan Pearce was the guilty party here. Another long ball into the penalty area. Danny Robinson had to punch clear. Dakota Lucas, was that handball outside the box? Lucas thought so. Danny Robinson wasn't in a hurry to see what Matt Conga had to say. And the replay, perhaps inconclusive. Penalty, 22 minutes. Cole Peverley makes no mistake. He scored last week from the penalty spot, and he does so again this week. 1-1. And game on. Good moment for Peverley, the former All-White. And then Connor Tinian. Dakota Lucas did all the build-up work. The marking wasn't the greatest. Connor Tinian just kept his cool. And with the left foot, opened up, shrugged off Roy Krishna like he wasn't there. Beats Danny Robinson, and it was 2-1. Now, at this juncture, Hawke's Bay were just two goals away from taking the game to extra time. Certainly a massive ask with almost an hour of the game still left to play, but more than coach Chris Greatholder would have wished for. And then 39 minutes, another opportunity. And look at that, could he have done a wee bit better, Stephen Hindmarch. It was a great through ball. He's outpaced Jake Butler, scuffs the first shot and gets no luck with the rebound. Well, Roy Krishna takes on Aaron Jones here, but what we don't see in the build-up to this goal is Hawke's Bay self-destructing in midfield. Cole Peverley came up short with a back pass to Bill Robertson, and Roy Krishna just nipped in, went straight at Aaron Jones. That extra yard of pace and the left foot shot gave Gillespie no hope, and that was 2-2. And 6-3 on aggregate. And there was an opportunity right near the death. Ryan DeVries, his curling shot hitting the crossbar. And that might well have put this game to bed. In fact, Richard Gillespie took one look at it and knew instantly that that was going to be a shot he could do nothing about. So, plenty for both coaches to think about. Paul Marshall will be slightly relieved that Waitakere have come back. And at halftime, it's Waitakere United 2, Hawke's Bay United 2. We'll see you back here very shortly for the second half. Welcome back to Fred Taylor Park. It's the second half of the ASB Premiership semi-final second leg between Hawke's Bay United and Waitakere United. We're locked at 2-2. Waitakere lead 6-3 on aggregate. And they're just 45 minutes away from their seventh consecutive ASB Premiership Grand Final. Can you believe that? It's an impressive record. And their pursuit of four in a row is very much alive. No team has ever won four consecutive ASB Premiership titles. Auckland City used to hold the record of three in a row between 2004 and 2007. Waitakere equaled that last season, and they can go one better this season. But at the moment, they've got their hands full with the Hawke's Bay United, who just simply won't give up. Of course, if we reflect on the first half, they had a number of opportunities to have scored perhaps even three or four goals. And you cast your mind to the plight of players like Jared Smith and Sean Lovemore, both strikers with a nose for goal, plenty of experience, a lot of pace, and both of them are out with long-term injuries. How they could have used them here today. Smith, of course, has an Achilles injury, and Sean Lovemore tore ankle ligaments at Bluewater Stadium back in the regular season. That's going to keep him out for up to 6 months, we're told. But the present group of Hawke's Bay players have acquitted themselves well here today. Lucas, Margaret, Heavily, Jones, good build up this for Hawke's Bay. Oh, and Rodiker checked his run. If he had kept it going, might have found himself with an extra valuable yard. Tinian whipped in away from, I think that's Aaron Scott. Whoa, and that's a handball. It's another penalty. Hawke's Bay with the brilliant start to the second half. There's a yellow card being shown as well. And an opportunity for Cole Peverley to make up for his earlier mistake and add to his goal tally as well. Well, is there a twist in the tail here? Well, it's been an absolutely absorbing match. Can Cole Peverley add to the drama? Can Danny Robinson add to the drama, for that matter? He went to his left in the first penalty. It doesn't make a difference this time. It was a powerful take. Hawke's Bay back in front. 3-2, they lead. Remarkable stuff. Who would have picked Hawke's Bay to come up to Fred Taylor Park and give an account of themselves like this? It's absolutely courageous stuff. And for Waitakere United, this is the second time they've been put in this position in two matches at Fred Taylor Park in recent times. It'll be something that will concern Coach Paul Marshall, that's for almost certain. So Waitakere lead by 6-4 on aggregate. Fergus Neal, can he get by Shelley? He's got a corner. Waitakere United 2, Hawke's Bay United 3, 6-4 in aggregate. We've had 5 minutes, or we're in the fifth minute of the second half, and we've already had a goal, a second penalty. Can Hawke's Bay add to the tally? It's not a great corner, to be fair. Heavily. Stephen Hoyle launches a long ball into the box. Robinson's underneath it and claims. Well, he had a wee shove afterwards, I think. Nothing that's going to bother Bill Robertson anytime soon. He's an experienced campaigner himself, used to the knocks. Rodica's miscued his clearance. Remarkable stuff. I wonder what is going through the mind of coach Chris Greatholder. He spent most of this game looking pensively from the technical area. Perry Cotton, his assistant, who he brought back in the off-season, is doing most of the standing. Experienced campaigner, Perry Cotton, part of the Napier City Rovers heritage, attached to Hawke's Bay United. Won Chatham Cups and National League titles in the old National League format with Napier City Rovers at Park Island. Can reel off a number of names here. One of them would be Andy Rennie, Andy Birchinow. Mick Waite, of course, who played and coached at Napier City Rovers, as we see Waitakere pouring forward in numbers. Dan Morgan. And that ball's not going to trouble Hawke's Bay anytime soon. Well, the game's starting to open up. There's gaps appearing everywhere. There's some tired legs out there. Well, a late challenge has resulted in a foul on Alan Pierce. Stephen Highmarch is the culprit. Could very well be a case of what might have been for Hawke's Bay when they get to the end of this match today. They really didn't turn up for the first leg. It was a masterclass delivered by Waitakere. They have a chance to get level again from a set play. Some 30 metres out, it's going to be Alan Pierce. Well, Gillespie had some work to do on the ground. Tries to get things moving again. And De Vries has picked Fergus Neal's pocket and has won a free kick for his troubles. Two Waitakere players have gone to warm up. It's Hashe Reninga and Jack Begley. Louis Del Monte is another option for Paul Marshall. In the defeat to Canterbury, he hardly put a foot wrong, Del Monte. So we have another look at that infringement by Fergus Neal. Now, can Waitakere get level? It's Morgan's free kick. Lofted into the far post. Whoa, suggestion of handball. Brian Shelley had his hands in the air. He felt that there might have been a hint of handball. Nothing doing from Matt Conga. Myers header, only as far as Tinian. It's a good ball forward. Chance for Hawke's Bay. Oh, and it's just gone wide. Another excellent chance for Hawke's Bay. It was an excellent pass from Connor Tinian. Just played it first time with the outside of the left. Stephen Highmarch got in behind Waitakere and the dipping volley just went wide. Oh, back with the action. Dakota Lucas. Hoyle. It's a corner for Hawke's Bay. Riveting stuff here at Fred Taylor Park. Two more goals for Hawke's Bay would level the scores on aggregate at 6-6. And it would be Hawke's Bay who would then have... oh, and the header's just gone wide. Another opportunity for Hawke's Bay. Well, if they got to 6-all, they would... Hawke's Bay would be the team that would go through to the final based on the away goals rule. Here's Tinian's corner. It was a good one, and Robertson came through, and it just glanced wide of the upright. Margit. Tinian, Hoyle. Good pace to this match. Hawke's Bay have not stopped giving it everything. Krishna. Well, he's gone past Peverly. Robertson's coming over to cut him off. Morgan. He's got Pierce. He's got DeVries in the box. Hawke's Bay have got to concentrate. They've got a free kick. Waitakere. So Alan Pierce will take it. Right foot in swinger. He's gone to the far post and it's cleared everybody. Going to be picked up by Tim Myers. So this is in a handy position. Belief growing perhaps for Hawke's Bay. Margaret's ball in. Cut out by Kinnean. Corner for Hawke's Bay again. So Tinian will go across to take the corner. Can Bill Robertson get a cleaner connection on it? Can Waitakere clear the danger? Oh, and it's as far as Peverly, who's miscued. Lucas has picked up the debris. Tinian. Lucas. Paul Marshall's on his feet. Tinian's ball in. Not a bad one at all. Easy take. Danny Robinson makes it look so easy under pressure. Over 100 games in the ASB Premiership, Danny Robinson. Aaron Scott's picked the ball up on the far side. Waitakere now. Launching an attack of their own. They've taken the free kick quickly. Robertson had to stretch out a leg to flick it off the foot of danger man Krishna.
Waitakere United would like to thank our major sponsors, AAC, DB, Grimshaw & Co, Snell Packaging, Lotto Sportswear, RQ Group, Northwest & Tour Leisure, City Fitness.
Dan Morgan's going to take the corner.
And we acknowledge the great support we received
in the 6 yard box. There's only three targets at the far post. Waitakere have left four back in defence. Hawke's Bay have left three up. There's the ball in. It's away by Hindmarch. Morgan winds in the cross. Not a bad one. Oh, it's in the back of the net. And it's Matt Kinnean. Excellent header from Kinnean. And Hawke's Bay have to do it all over again. There's the ball in from Dan Morgan, excellently flighted. Always an advantage for a player of the height of Matt Kinnean. He got the header on target, kick calm. Richard Gillespie didn't have a chance. Waitakere 3, Hawke's Bay 3. 7-4 on aggregate. So 1 hour into the game, and we've had six goals. Neil's free kick, lofted in. Peverly's nodded it back in. There's Hawke's Bay players lining up, and that's hit the crossbar. Oh, and Hawke's Bay are in front again. The goals just keep on coming. Extraordinary stuff. Hawke's Bay do not know the meaning of defeat. Stephen Hoyle has been credited with the goal. 7-5 on aggregate, 4-3 to Hawke's Bay. Well, no matter the outcome of today's tie, Coach Chris Greatholt is going to be very proud of a team. Oh, and Pierce has just knocked that one wide. Tell you now, I've seen a raft of ASB Premiership semi-finals over the seasons. This is shaping to be an all-time classic. There was the original header by I think Connor Tinian that hit the crossbar. The clearance only went as far as Stephen Hoyle, who lashed it home with the right foot. Danny Robinson didn't have a hope there. Tinian, still Tinian, drags his shot wide. Butler. That ball just cut out by Aaron Jones. He had to be at full stretch for it. Well, that's given straight to Waitakere. A chance perhaps for the minor premiers to exert some more dominance, or at least some further pain on Hawke's Bay, because each time Hawke's Bay score, Waitakere pull one back. Morgan onto that left foot, goes to the far post. Gillespie comes and punches. Butler shapes to shoot, decides to pass, and Margetts has given it straight back to him. Now Pierce. Matthews. Myers. Krishna. Oh, and a chance for De Vries. He scores. It's 4-each. Amazing stuff. And as I was saying, each time Hawke's Bay United score,
drawing the goal scorer up again to 4-all, number 20, Ryan De Vries.
The minor premiers bounce back and show exactly why they are the top team after the regular season. De Vries on 65 minutes and this amazing fixture just throws up more permutations. Eight, five on aggregate. Well, Waitakere and Canterbury have in the past exchanged a number of goals in semi-final action over two legs. This could be going quite close to the highest number of goals scored in an ASB Premiership semi-final series. Is there more to come? There's plenty of time. Heavily. Hoyle, shot from Hindmarch. Deflection goes as far as Rodica. De Vries has picked it up. Well, that's fallen kindly for Bill Robertson, who nods it all the way back to Gillespie.
Hey,
Well, a late challenge. And it's going to result in a talking to at least. And it's going to be a card as well. Connor Tinian for a foul on Ryan DeVries. No, sorry. I've put you wrong there. It's Josh Margetts who's booked. And a substitution, the first one of the afternoon. Alan Pierce is being withdrawn. Jack Begley is being injected into proceedings. Waitakere United 4, Hawke's Bay United 4. 8-5 on aggregate to Waitakere United.
Substitution for Waitakere United, number 10, Alan Pierce, being replaced by number 3, Jack Beverly.
Dan Morgan. Myers for DeVries. Cuts inside Margetts. Butler might have a go here. Krishna for the hat trick. Roy Krishna, he scores, it's 5-4. And it's a hat-trick for Roy Krishna. Simply sensational. Excellent goal by the Fijian international. And this game takes yet another dramatic turn. Absolutely breathless stuff from both teams. I said before that this form of knockout football has taken its fair amount of critics from time to time. But we've had 9 goals today. We've had end-to-end football. Both sides have covered themselves in credit, I would say. Rodica. Margetts trying to get forward. Myers has just pushed him out of the way. 17 goals this season for Roy Krishna. Now DeVries up against Bill Robertson. Good defending from Peverly. The substitute Begley's got it. Overlapping run by Scott. There's no targets in the penalty area. Butler. Oh, maybe a suggestion that it hit Cole Peverly on the hand, which would have been irony of ironies today, considering he's taken 2 penalties himself. Oh, and so close for Hawke's Bay. How often have we said that, though, today? Fergus Neal. It's almost been exhibition-style football, but with a cutting edge. Look how close Lucas was to getting on the end of that. Substitution for Waitakere, Roy Krishna, the hat-trick hero. Has been replaced by Miloš Nikolic. It's been a masterclass by Roy Krishna today. 17 goals this season. Five, 4 Waitakere lead, 9-5 on aggregate. 14 goals in 2 games. at an average of 7 per match. Margots, not a bad ball into the 6-yard box. It's well dealt with by Waitakere. Four all, nine, well, sorry, 5-4. So Waitakere 5, Hawke's Bay 4, 9-5 on aggregate. Bill Robertson's header. Flicked on by Tinian. Dakota Lucas. You can almost bet your house is going to be another goal at any time. Nikolic, he's done Bill Robertson a treat. De Vries is unmarked at the far post. Nikolic. Oh, and I don't know about that. I don't think that was an intentional back pass. That's a pretty generous interpretation of the back pass law. You could tell from the body language of Aaron Jones that he's mishit this. Take a look. Nikolic whips it in. Jones, now he goes to trap it and it hits his foot. Balloons in the air. And the goalkeeper's taking it. That's not a deliberate back pass in my view. It all comes down to, I think, understanding what was going on in that particular situation and reading it for what it was. If you take a literal interpretation, let's say you haven't played as a centre-half, then you're going to get a decision like we've just got. Chance for Waitakere. Butler! Oh, and straight into somebody's face. I think it was Richard Gillespie. Jake Butler can hit them from 30 metres, and if you get hit in the face from 5, you're going to feel it, and Richard Gillespie felt that. Touch from Morgan, and then smashed straight into Gillespie's face. It would be tantamount to being hit by a freight train. Another look at it. Wallop. Now, some suggestion that perhaps Richard Gillespie's also got a bleeding nose here. And if that's the case, well, the policy on players with blood about their person is pretty clear. This could even be a substitution, perhaps. That's the indication we're getting here from the Waitakere United physio who's on the scene. Gillespie's not wanting to have a bar of it.
Waitakere United would like to thank our sporting commercial partners, Billfish Cafe, Tags R Us, the Aussie Butcher.
Well, knowing Gillespie as the competitor he has been over the years, he's not going to sign off for Fred Taylor Park. Under any circumstances, he won the O-League here as a player and went to 2 Club World Cups with Waitakere. Just have a quick recap of the goal that sealed Roy Krishna's hat-trick. Lined it up on his right foot. He cuts inside Aaron Jones, hits it with his left into the roof of the net. Goal number 17 of the season for the Fijian international, the Rocket Roy Krishna.
Number 19, Dan.
He can hit them with his left, he can hit them with his right.
11,
and he's going to go pretty close, I think, for the ASB Premiership Player of the Year. He's just been in absolutely stunning form. And the picture of pure joy and happiness on the face of Krishna as he receives the congratulations of his teammates. play resumes. We're inside the final quarter of an hour. And Waitakere United are looking good. They've been severely tested here today. They've been put under close scrutiny, and they've come up one goal to the good so far in terms of their advantage here today. But hats off to a brave Hawke's Bay United. They've given everything here. And if they had have had a little bit more luck and taken chances when they came up, they could well have put Waitakere under even more scrutiny than they have. Oh, and there's a chance for Butler to add to the tally. He's round Gillespie. Waitakere are on their way to the ASB Premiership Grand Final. There can be no doubt now. Jake Butler has put the icing on the cake for the West Auckland outfit. 6-4 today. 10-5 on aggregate. Just trundles it into the back of the net. And you just hope for Hawke's Bay United's sake that they don't disappear under an avalanche of goals. That would be a fate most cruel. Robertson's header goes as far as Del Monte. Matt Kinnean. And the temperature here, I have to say, it's been sitting in the mid to late 20s here. All afternoon, no relief from a breeze. Matthews, Butler. Kinnean opens up a foot, finds Nikolic, who gives that straight to Hoyle. Tried to look for Lucas. Jake Butler. Nikolic. Well, the question will be, who do Waitakere United face in the grand final? De Vriso can still add to the tally. It's Del Monte. Good save by Gillespie. Tinian. Heavily. Physical challenge from Kinnean. Deemed fair. Del Monte's handed it over to De Vries. Begley. Free kick. Of course, Sunday's semi-final second leg is between Auckland City and Canterbury United. Kiwitea Street. Auckland City have a 2-1 advantage there.
Goalkeeper Richard Gillespie will be replaced by Danny Drake.
Well, here's an interesting moment. Richard Gillespie's coming off with 10 minutes to go, and Daniel Drake, the reserve goalkeeper for Hawke's Bay United, former Ngarawahia United goalkeeper, by the way, takes an ASB Premiership appearance under his belt at the knockout stages. So Nikolic is going to take the free kick. It's only two-man wall for Hawke's Bay United. Oh, had plenty of power, and it's taken Harley Rodiker out. Matthews. Not a great first touch by Jack Begley. It's hooked clear by Hawke's Bay. Myers. Well, this has been a great advertisement for the ASB Premiership today's game. I cannot speak highly enough of Hawke's Bay United's attitude and commitment. Well, it's a yellow card for Tim Myers. And the resilience and character of Waitakere United to keep coming back. Every time they're asked a question, they've had an answer and then some. Heavily launches this one into the penalty box. Away by Myers. Fergus Neal's clipped ball back into the penalty area is a harmless one. Well, double substitution looming for Hawke's Bay United. I think it's about giving some of their bench players some experience. Ross Haviland, former Waitakere United player, is coming on. Fane Morgan is another player. With an academy background at Hawke's Bay. He's played under Dion Adams, who's the youth coach at Hawke's Bay United.
And number 10, Stephen Hoyle.
Stephen Hoyle is off. Jack Begley's header, away by Robertson. The touch by Tinian. It's been a real standout today for Hawke's Bay. Switch of play from Dakota Lucas. Invites Robertson to pick it up. Hawke's Bay players have funneled forward. They're not leaving much at the back here. Five on aggregate. 6-4 on the day in favour of Waitakere in a match that has seesawed. Oh, and his problems. De Vries has left Neil in his wake. It's Nikolic. Nikolic straight into the back of the head of Stephen Hindmarch. Handball by Haviland. Milos Nikolic packs plenty of punch in these shots he takes. Del Monte will take the free kick. Well, first touch wasn't great, the second touch was handball. Del Monte's ball in. Interesting one. No takers. Daniel Drake will take the goal kick. Hawke's Bay United playing with two at the back now. They've committed everybody forward. Drake's first kick, not a great one. Just under 5 minutes of normal time remaining. Waitakere United's pursuit of a seventh consecutive grand final is all but confirmed. The pursuit of four championships in a row is another matter, of course, that's going to be answered in the next 8 or 9 days' time. And Paul Marshall's dream of a potential treble is also alive. Minor Premiership, ASB Charity Cup and ASB Premiership. Grand Final, very much on his mind. Robertson, he's got Lucas making a run just in behind Kaneen. Hindmarch, he's looking for somebody to come short to his feet here. Morgan, Tinian, Aaron Jones looking for a shot perhaps. Jones, Hindmarch, Jones still has it. Now Morgan tried to flick one through. He was looking for a run, but I don't know if Aaron Jones has got the legs for that this late in the match. Been kept busy all afternoon. Aaron Jones. Tinian. Cuts inside Matthews. He's running into heavy traffic though, Connor Tinian. Robertson does well to win the header. Lucas. You just wonder how Hawke's Bay would have gone with Jared Smith and Sean Lovemore. They've done pretty well without them, to be completely fair, but 10 goals conceded over two games tells another story. Nikolic. Well, ambitious effort by Nikolic. Aaron Scott's header picked up by Peverley. Nice switch of play by Cole Peverley. Fane Morgan. Connor Tinian. Morgan still going. Cut into the box and a shot, and it's just wide. Stephen Hindmarch. Intelligent run into the penalty area. The swivel and shot. Here's Fane Morgan's ball. Nice use of the body. And it flashes across the face of goal. It was not as close as I first thought. Just over a minute and a half remaining. Waitakere United 6, Hawke's Bay United 4. 10-5 on aggregate. 15 goals over two games in the ASB Premiership semi-finals. Del Monte's overhit the pass intended for Nikolic. Oh, and he's come up short again, Beverly. Those legs must be feeling pretty heavy at the moment, along with all of his teammates. They can be exceptionally proud of their efforts, Hawke's Bay. Five minutes of additional time minimum to be added on.
There will be 5 minutes of added time for the remainder of this match. A minimum of 5 minutes added time.
Drake with a long ball. Looking for Fane Morgan. Robertson again and again. Well, Chris Greatholder told me at the halfway point. Oh, and that's a horrible mistake by Jones. It goes unpunished. He puts his hand up. That would have been hard on Aaron Jones. It would have been hard on Daniel Drake. And Ryan De Vries, who's worked tirelessly this afternoon, has just come up short. It was just an absolute gift for him, one that he would normally take advantage of, Ryan De Vries. Nikolic up against Jones on that right foot. The shot, good save by Daniel Drake. Heavily. Haviland looking for Lucas. Little step over, drags it back into the path of Tinian. Morgan. Lucas. Haviland's cross. Get it clear by Scott. Hindmarch, heavy legs. Lucas was the intended target. It's just come up for Hawke's Bay. Drake's ball, not a bad one actually. Looking for Morgan and Lucas. It's Tim Myers who tidies up. And a free kick to Waitakere United. There can only be seconds remaining now. Oh, and Milos Nikolic is in the clear, and he's put it wide. Well, he had plenty of time to pick his spot. He tried to curl it into the far post. Daniel Drake got his positioning bang on. Del Monte, De Vries, Robertson takes a swing. Well, Chris Greatholder was telling me that a lot of the changes he's implemented this season required the buy-in of Bill Robertson, and you can see how much he's enjoyed his football this season. He's turned in another commanding leader's performance. But it hasn't been enough. Not today. Today's belonged to Waitakere. Look at this from Dakota Lucas. Couple of step overs. Tim Myers, eagle-eyed defending, keeping him at bay. Shelley. Del Monte, De Vries. The match has slowed to a walking pace, and referee Matt Conger would be as well to call time now. Ball into the penalty area is here to clear by Peverley. It's going to be a corner. Conga checks his watch. Nikolic is coming short for it. And that's it. It's all over. An absorbing game of football that receives a warm round of applause from the spectators, and rightly so. Waitakere have triumphed by 6-4 today. They've overwhelmed Hawke's Bay 10-5 on aggregate. But you'll go a long way before you see an entertaining football match like this. This was an absolute joy from start to finish to watch. And Waitakere United have advanced to the ASB Premiership Grand Final. I wouldn't say they've done it easily, but it's been convincing.
check out their website, and we will update our website as soon as we get that information.
Seventh straight grand final appearance for Waitakere United. The opportunity to seal four championships in a row.
The club rooms are open upstairs. We've been sitting out in the heat. We might enjoy a cold beer upstairs. Maybe after that.
Let's take a look back on the highlights of a wonderful semi-final second leg. Just 2 minutes in, Roy Krishna got the ball rolling, so to speak. This left foot shot left Richard Gillespie in a bit of a tangle. It was Krishna's first attack at the Hawke's Bay defence. He's hit it with his left foot. Not a lot of power on it. Suggestion that it may have taken a deflection on its way in. And that was 1-0 after just 2 minutes. 5-1 on aggregate. But there was a lot more to come. Just over 10 minutes later, this effort from Dakota Lucas, checking onto his right foot, whips in the shot. It hits Danny Robinson's left hand upright. Brian Shelley defended this really well, making sure that Dakota Lucas didn't have a full-on blast at goal. Within 2 minutes of this, a long ball forward by Hawke's Bay. Brian Shelley got himself into a spot of bother with Dakota Lucas, just overshoots the mark. The ball gets tangled in his feet. Lucas picks it up. Connor Tinian's run, was that Stephen Hall's run to the near post? And Dakota Lucas, well, we see there, he just gave a bit of a nudge to Shelley, came up with it, hits a side netting. 17th minute, shot from Alan Pierce, no power on it though, no trouble for Gillespie. Did well to cut inside the defender, but look at that, that's an easy one. This ball in, punch clear by Danny Robinson, but then it became something of a lottery. Robinson had a second nibble at it. There was an appeal by the Bay players for a handball on the part of Robinson just outside the box. Hard to say. And then this. Penalty shout. Matt Kinnean, doesn't look like there's any contact there for me, but Hawke's Bay come up with a penalty. And Cole Peverley, for the second time in this fixture up till then, slots it home from the penalty spot. Cool, calm and collected, Cole Peverley. One all. Then Lucas set up Connor Tinian, who does well to shove Roy Krishna out of his way, and then he had to deal with Danny Robinson, and in the back of the net, 2-1, Hawke's Bay United, and was the miracle on? There was no reason to suggest that it might not be. Six minutes before the halftime break, another opportunity. This time it was Stephen Hindmarch, who breaks clear of the Waitakere defence. Shot wasn't as good as it could have been. Straight into the legs of Danny Robinson. And there was no luck with the follow-through. Had that turned 3-1, well, we might have had a real show on our hands here. Then this mistake from Peverley opened up the chance for Roy Krishna to take on Aaron Jones. Left foot shot, rifled into the back of the net. And that broke Hawke's Bay's hearts. 2-2 at half-time. Look at that change of pace and the deadly finish from Krishna. Happy days, goal number 16 of the season for Krishna. Ryan DeVries could have given them the lead again. Hits the crossbar with that left foot curling shot. Look at that. Well, this was a clear-cut penalty. The header straight into the hand. Cole Peverley sticking the ball in the back of the net. No chance for Danny Robinson. Peverley electing for power over placement. His third goal of the tie. Then just on the hour mark, Dan Morgan winds in this cross. And Matt Kinnean rose above everybody in the Bay box and just guided this header into the back of the net. former Napier boy, enjoying his moment here at Fred Taylor Park against some familiar old faces. Well, this one came back off the crossbar. The woodwork got a good solid workout today. Stephen Hoyle's right foot shot lashed into the back of the net. And that put Hawke's Bay United 4-3 up. Excellent finish. The header had Robinson in trouble. And the finish was deadly. Well, Waitakere were level again. This time it was Ryan De Vries with the finish. 4-4. And then Roy Krishna for his hat trick with a left foot shot. Goal number 17 of the season for the Fijian international. Absolutely magnificent stuff. And that really more or less gave Waitakere a good firm side of the grand final. That made it 5-4. And then with time running out, Hawke's Bay running out of energy. Jake Butler round Richard Gillespie. Easy tap in for the skipper. Waitakere United 6, Hawke's Bay United 4. Hawke's Bay had just run out of energy. They had pushed further and further forward in an attempt to retrieve the situation. And Butler made no mistake. Well, we can join Olivier Hook, who's got Waitakere United coach Paul Marshall alongside him for his view of today's game.
Paul, what a match today.
Yeah, it was a bit of an end-to-end contest, wasn't it? You know, we probably didn't do that well in the first half and continued to concede goals, but it was what was pleasing, I guess, is that we kept battling back and we kept equalising, and then once we got our noses in front, I think the game really turned in our favour.
The most important, you qualify for the final next week here.
Yeah, very much so. You know, I mean, today, you know, we were 4-4-4-1 up, I think, after the first leg away, so we had a few away goals up our sleeve as well, and we knew that a reasonable performance would be probably enough, and you know, probably a little bit complacent, I would suggest. But by and large, you know, you've got to be happy still with a 6-4 win. You know.
Thank you very much. Juan.
Thank you. Cheers.
Roy. His team's appearance in the grand final. Will it be against Auckland City or Canterbury United? Remains to be seen. And one man who's going to be very important in that wash-up is going to be Roy Krishna, who scored a hat-trick today. And he's with Olivier Hook.
So, Roy, a good match today. You qualify for the final, but it was quite difficult.
I know, you know, we started well, and then suddenly they scored two goals. A bit of not good defending, and now we need to improve in our final. So happy with the win. So
the next 2 months will be really busy. You have the final next week, and also the Champions League. We'll say Champions League just after.
Yeah, no. Now we're gonna focus on the final first, and then if it's done, then next thing is our league. So first is the final.
So only important events coming next month.
Yeah, I know. Just most important is our recovery. You know, we need to rest well, and you know, need a good ice bath, and then ready for the final, and then recovery well, and then prepare for the big games. Holy.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you.
So those are the views of Roy Krishna and Paul Marshall. First things first for Krishna. One eye is on the ASB Premiership Grand Final. Who that will be against is decided on Sunday when Auckland City host Canterbury United in the semi-final second leg. It's been an absolute pleasure to bring you all the action from Fred Taylor Park in the second leg of the semi-final. On behalf of OFC TV and everybody here at Fred Taylor Park, I wish you well and see you again.